Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Claudio. So glad that you're here. Today I'm sharing with you how to create hyperlink buttons in Adobe Express. Now this is different than hyperlink text, which you can already create in Adobe Express. So I got a little special hack that I'll share with you. So let's go ahead and get started. Here's a project I have opened up in Adobe Express. And what I'm going to do is create a flyer for my website, for some photography tips, and for my YouTube channel. So let's first start with adding some text for the website. So I'm going to go ahead and choose my text. I'm going to go ahead and go with my brand font, or I should say the font that I love using for my website. And here is my website here. I'm going to go ahead and resize this text, put it down here towards the bottom. I think I'm going to add a shape around it, maybe a box. So let's go ahead and use this one right here. Let's make sure the color is white. And there's several ways I can add a hyperlink. With the text box selected, if you look up here on the menu option on the left, text, you see link right here. You can also right click on the actual text and you'll have the link option. And what you'll need to do is add your website. Make sure you check that you've done it. It's valid and there it is. It is hyperlinked. So the next step is to add some buttons that we're going to hyperlink. Now, at the moment, this is a hack. So what I'm sharing with you is a bit of a hack to create hyperlink button. So first off, let me go ahead and find an icon of a camera over here on the left in Elements. I'm going to go ahead and go with this camera right here, and you'll see we'll move this down over here, make it a bit smaller, and I'm going to go ahead and change the fill color to white. And now in order to create this hyperlink to my photography tips, I cannot hyperlink in the image at the moment. So this is where the hack will come in. We're going to go ahead and add a text box. And what I'm going to do is use some box lettering. I'm going to go with H and I'm going to go with E. Maybe add another he there. And what we'll do is we will resize this to fit over the button here. And we're going to change the color here to black just so we can see it. And what I'm going to do is resize this so that it covers up most of that button there. So I want to go pretty much edge to edge there. And so what we'll do is just make a slight adjustment here so that it covers up most of it. All right, there we go. So now we're going to do the same process. We're going to right click here and link. And this time I will hyperlink to my photography tips. And it is added. And now what we'll do, here's where the trick comes in. We're going to bring the opacity down. And that will ensure that our box right here is hyperlinked, or I should say this button is hyperlinked. So that is the first one that I'll do here. The next one I will do is add a button to my YouTube channel. So we'll go ahead and bring this button here. I created this with multiple design asset shapes here. I just made my own little YouTube button. And so what we're going to do is repeat the process. And instead of just adding a new text, what I'm going to do is click on the button here and you'll see that it is text. You can see that right there. Just in case, we'll bring the opacity back up. And what I'm going to do is duplicate by right clicking, duplicate. So I have the other text box. We're going to bring this over here. We're going to make sure, and over here on the right hand side, we're going to drag that to the top layer. There we go. So now it's covering up the YouTube button there. Now what I need to do is right click and go to the link option here. We're going to remove that because that is for the other website. And I'm going to go ahead now and paste my YouTube channel here, youtube.com/IamClaudius. And here we go. Now it is linked. So let's go ahead and bring that opacity all the way back down. Let's go ahead and go back to the original one here. Bring that opacity down. And now let's go ahead and publish this. We're going to download and we're going to select PDF. This is the only way your links will work is by downloading a PDF. Let's go ahead and do that. Let's go ahead and download and we'll test those links out. All right, here is the downloaded PDF. So let's go ahead and test the buttons out. Here is the button for my YouTube channel. You see right there, we're gonna click on that and it should open up to my YouTube channel here. Let's check out the other buttons. Here is my photography tips. And now let's check out my website. There you go. All three websites were hyperlinked from my document that I created in Adobe Express. And that's how to create hyperlink buttons in Adobe Express. And that's your turn to give it a try. Don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, click the bell to be notified for future videos just like this one right here. And don't forget to share this video with your friends. Thanks again for stopping by and watching this video. And as always, have fun creating. Peace.